land of Canaan knew many warring tribes, but the Hebrews and the pagan Hittites managed to live side by side in an uneasy truce. The Hebrews had long had a custom that the firstborn son inherited his father's wealth and blessing. But in one family, there had been twins, an occurrence that was to spark a struggle and the test of a man's strength. Isaac, leader of the tribe of Israel, had fathered twins. Esau was his favorite, a hunter and a warrior. He was also firstborn by virtue of minutes. Jacob was the younger, a quiet man, a thinker. And while it was Esau who excelled at feats of strength, it was Jacob who would face the test of fate.
Sister, you are rooting against your own brother.
I'm sorry, Apex, but Esau means more to me than any of you. Come on, throw him, Esau!
You've worked up a good thirst, son. Drink.
Thank you, Father.
Is your wrist hurt?
Oh, it's just a scratch, Mother.
You tricked him.
Naturally. How can you Hittites hope to match wits with the son of Isaac and the grandson of Abraham?
And what about Jacob? Doesn't he have the same bloodlines?
Of course he does.
Then let's put the theory to the test. Come on, Jacob. Let's you and I do battle.
Apex, perhaps a word of caution. My brother has better things to do with his time.
When Jacob chooses to wrestle, it will be with someone greater than the likes of you.
You waste your time in these foolish games, son. I'd much rather you use your skill hunting the venison I so dearly love.
Father, I must confess, at the moment I have my eyes on a different sort of game.
Esau.
Did you comb the wool?
Yes, I've combed it and washed it and combed it again. Seems all I'm good for is woman's work. You'll be teaching me to use the spindle next.
What's come over you?
Nothing. Except that I resent being made the brunt of all the jokes around here while Esau reaps all the glory. Like this afternoon when Apex challenged me to wrestle, and Esau felt called upon to protect me.
But he's your brother. He loves you.
I don't need his protection. I'm tired of being humiliated.
Oh, no one's humiliating you. It's just that you and Esau are different, that's all.
Is that why Father prefers him?
He loves you both, just as I do. You're both our sons.
He loves Esau more.
Well, maybe just a little. Just as I prefer you.
It's not right. Just because he was born a few moments before me, all the rights and privileges of being firstborn.
You're forgetting the prophecy.
Prophecies?
Jacob, listen to me, please. Jacob, as soon as I felt two heartbeats and knew that I was going to have twins, the Lord came to me and said that there were two nations in my womb and that one people would be stronger than the other people. And then he added that the elder would serve the younger. You're forgetting that.
Then why didn't I get the birthright in the first place?
Because he was born first.
Well, that's what I'm asking. Why? If he was meant to serve me, why was he born first?
The Almighty has his reasons, and it's not for us to question them. The most we can do is hope to carry out his will.
And how can you do that, Mother? By stealing Esau's birthright from me?
If God wills it.
You would actually steal from one son to give another?
I'll do anything the Lord commands me. All of Esau's actions indicate that he isn't interested in his birthright. And if that's so, then he doesn't deserve to have it.
You're too hard on Esau. He's my brother and I love him. And our first duty is to try and make him aware of his responsibility.
Well, that won't be easy. He's very set in his ways.
Jacob was aware he had assumed a difficult task. For it was not responsibility Esau desired, but pleasure. Knowing that, Jacob made his way to the Hittite camp.
Ha, 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 ha
your God now, Esau.
The Lord is too busy to be concerned with these petty games of chance. Well, little brother, what brings you here?
You, Esau.
I wish you had come on a luckier day. I've done nothing but lose.
I want to talk to you.
Well, perhaps later. Why don't you relax, have some day wine? You know Bashima.
I wish to speak with you now.
Well, speak.
Come over here with me.
I know better than to argue with my little brother.
What is it, Jacob?
Can't you guess, my brother?
I am no good at guessing games. Now speak, before it gets dark.
Why do you spend your time here among the Hittites? Do you think so little of your birthright that you squander it among the pagans?
What are you talking about?
Our father Isaac is not long to live. When he dies, you, as firstborn, will have the sacred obligation to judge your fellow men, to decide all disputes wisely and with prayer.
What is this talk of birthrights? Look, the light fails. If I dally longer, our father will not have venison.
Put off sport and hunting for once. Let this be the day you start to face your responsibilities.
Little brother, I leave that to you.
Esau, as usual, ignored his brother's advice. The hunt for his father's venison took him deep into the mountains. A determined hunter, he would not return without his kill. He pushed onward, ignoring the storm and the fact he was going further and further from his camp.
Esau didn't come home last night. I'm worried about him.
He's probably with his Hittite harlot.
No, he went hunting. It was late. I warned him not to, and then the storm broke.
Esau can take care of himself. Did you speak to him?
When I reminded him of his responsibilities, he said he leaves such matters to me.
That's as it's meant to be. I love Esau, but he's not worthy of leading our tribe in serving God.
What makes me so worthy?
Well, at least you don't consort with Hittites. I'll be leaving. I must get back to your father. Take care.
I will, Mother. Oh, Lord, give me a sign. If I am meant to lead the tribe of Isaac and Abraham, then show me how it can be done. I don't want to hurt my brother, Lord. But you hurt him. He doesn't seem to care. Show me the way, and I promise you'll have no better servant all the days of my life.
We're getting worried about you.
No more than I, little brother. No more than I.
What are you cooking?
Ah, nothing much. Just a simple stew of lamb and lentils.
Nothing much. It's like a manna from heaven. May I have some?
If only I'd known you were coming. As it is, I barely made enough for one.
Then make more.
There's no time. I have to inspect the flocks all the way to Gaza. I won't have another chance to eat till nightfall.
Little brother, I am dying of hunger.
It's only an hour's walk to Isaac's tent. I'm sure Mother will have something for you there.
I cannot walk another step. May I have a taste?
Of course.
I'd give anything in the world for that stew.
You mean that? Anything?
Would I say it if I didn't mean it?
Even your birthright?
I'm joking.
The whole pot of stew for your birthright.
Here I am starving to death, and the man speaks to me of birthrights.
I'm waiting for your answer.
You know how I feel about that. I don't care about power or responsibility. You're much better at that sort of thing than I am.
Then it's a bargain?
Yes, it's a bargain.
Eat well, my brother.
Bad, eh, Peck?
I'll wager 20 silver shekels you can do no better.
Done.
Well done, brother, well done.
Talk is cheap for those that sit and watch. I'll bet the same amount you can't take Esau's bow and hit any part of the target.
I accept.
He'll never do it.
I'll use my own bow.
Not so fast, Jacob. I stipulated Esau's bow. It was part of the wager.
I want it back from you tonight.
Jacob, don't be angry. The world knows that you're not a hunter.
Nor yet a bender of bows.
Why are you upset?
I'm not upset.
And why are you pacing back and forth like a caged animal? You'll wear yourself out, Jacob.
Don't concern yourself, Mother. I may not be able to bend a bow, but I'm still strong enough to walk.
Such a trifling incident. Don't let it bother you.
It's just one of many. People look upon me as some kind of freak.
Well, all that will change when you inherit Esau's birthright.
I'd like to believe that. But I'm beginning to think it was Esau who tricked me. He must have realized that birthright meant nothing without our father's blessing.
Nevertheless, you will prevail.
You're not falling back on that old prophecy again.
Do you doubt God's word? Do you, my son? Have faith, Jacob.
You've lost again, Esau. That makes 700 silver shekels.
Aren't you worried I may not pay up?
Why should we be worried, Esau? You'll be a rich man someday. Your father is old and you are the firstborn.
No, you don't understand. I'm no longer the firstborn.
How does one stop being firstborn?
I sold my birthright to Jacob.
You what?
It's not so hard to grasp. I just sold it. That's all.
What did you get in exchange for it?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you. Well, shall we continue our game here? Oh, I see. My credit's no longer so good, eh? Well, you needn't worry about your money. You'll be paid. I still have my father's blessing, and he can't take that away from me.
I've never heard of such a thing.
What can we do about it?
I'll tell you one thing we can't do. We can't let Jacob succeed to Isaac's position.
You mean kill him?
Not so fast. That would bring both Isaac and Esau down on our heads. And end the peace between the tribes.
What then?
We must destroy something of Jacob's that's dearer to him than life itself. Something that will forever keep him from his inheritance. His reputation.
Impossible! Man is paragon of virtue.
Otherwise, we would not need you, sister.
What would you have me do? Ply him with wine?
He does not drink.
Then shall I lull him with music? I could have a sauda play the harp.
Better for you to be alone with him.
Ah, then I am to be seductive.
It would frighten him off quicker than anything else.
What then?
Ask him about his God. It's the one subject their tribe can never resist.
But suppose Esau returns and finds us together.
He will. I'll make sure of it.
Esau is a headstrong man. He'll be furious.
I'm counting on that.
Are you trying to drive a wedge between us?
Our purpose is to create a scandal which will ruin Jacob's reputation. But when Esau learns that you did it to restore his birthright, he'll be closer to you than ever.
If Esau wishes to speak with me, why doesn't he come here?
I do not know. All I know is, Bashemoth asked if any of us knew Jacob. And when I said I did, she asked if I would deliver this message.
To meet Esau in her tent.
Those were her words.
It's possible he may have been hurt.
Esau?
Come in. Come in, Jacob.
Esau's not here.
He'll be back presently. Make yourself comfortable.
I'll wait outside.
Oh, no, please. I want to talk to you. I'd like to learn more about your God.
Perhaps you should speak with someone whose faith is more perfect than mine.
Do you mean you do not believe in him?
Of course I believe in him. The question is, does he believe in me?
I do not understand.
I'm merely saying that it's much easier to talk about God when you're quite sure you've found favor in his eyes.
Well, then why not make him a sacrifice? That's what we do.
It's not that simple. Sacrifices are all very well, but in our religion, a man is judged by his deeds. And it's important for him to recognize the choices in his life.
What's the matter with you two? You've been laughing and talking behind my back all day.
If we're hunting, then let's hunt. The chase is no place for girlish chatter.
You're right, Isa.
All right, out with it.
It really doesn't concern you.
More to do with Jacob.
What about Jacob?
It's really so ridiculous. It doesn't even bear repeating. But gossip has it that Jacob is in love with Bashemoth.
Rubbish.
You would find it funny.
Not the way you think. The whole idea is...
Just as I was telling Hassan, it's a waste of time to believe what the gossips are saying.
Which is?
That while you are out hunting, Jacob is amusing himself in Bashima's tent.
Ridiculous. Well, it's no use. This one's gone. This is what comes when you don't keep your mind on the hunt. I'm finished for the day.
If it's all the same to you, Hassan and I will try a little bit longer.
Do what you will.
And it was then my grandfather Abraham made a solemn covenant with God.
Does one inch into agreements with your God?
Every man makes a covenant with God. If we follow the right path, he rewards us. If not...
Oh, it's getting hot in here. Oh, and how does one know which is the right path?
I'm not really sure. Personally, I try and follow a course which will serve my people best. But then I don't know if I'm serving them or my own vanity.
Jacob, you're remarkable.
That disturbs me, Bashima.
So, there you are. Where else should I be? You want to speak to me?
Yes. Someone had told me, my own brother.
Please, it's not what it looks like.
I suppose you were telling each other stories. I was telling her about God.
God. Now I've heard everything. God?
What's come over you? Did you want me here or not? Did I want you here? I've no time for word games. I must get back to my flocks.
Your flocks? They're your flocks now, little brother? Can't you even wait till father is cold in the ground?
Esau, I'm beginning to lose patience.
Jacob, you will lose more than that. I promise you.
You don't think she and I...
No, no. I think you were probably trying to convert her. If there's one thing she's interested in, it's religion. Just look at her.
It's not what it seems... I swear it.
Esau, what can you be thinking?
I'm thinking, little brother, that you sought to rob me of more than my birthright.
Oh, you're mad! Am I?
No, Esau!
Am I mad, Jacob?
We'll soon see. Farewell, little brother.
Your time has come, Jacob. Make your peace with God. Do what you have to do.
Do not mention God's name.
It's you who need his forgiveness, not I.
Make an end of it, then. If you believe that of me, I no longer wish to live.
No. You won't trick me this time.
It was I who was fooled into coming here. She sent a messenger, said you wished to speak to me. You can ask him if you'd like. His name is Perua.
Perhaps it was for you this blade was meant.
It was Apex's idea. I only went along with it because of my love for you. We thought that if Jacob was involved in a scandal, that you would regain your birthright.
You fool. Do you think I would have renounced my birthright if I hadn't wished to do so? If I had really wanted it, do you think I would have agreed to marry you?
Marry her?
That's right, little brother. You're the first in our family to know.
Don't do it, Esau. Just imagine how upset mother and father will be if you marry a pagan.
My father has his ways, I have mine. Let us speak of it no more. It is done.
A drought fell upon the land of Canaan. What little water remained was gradually used until there was nothing left but a barren wasteland where life could not long survive.
It's because of Esau's sin that the Lord has afflicted us with this drought. He should never have married the daughter of a Hittite.
He's young. The hot blood courses through his veins. What would you have him do?
Oh, anything but that. And you closed your eyes at his carrying on with Bashemoth. You're to blame for this.
Peace, woman. I never intended for him to marry her.
And yet you intend that he succeed you.
And so he shall. I won't sacrifice him for one mistake.
And your father was willing to sacrifice you.
That was for God, to whom we owe everything. He has the right to demand everything in return.
Isaac, you would find favor with the Lord if you preferred Jacob.
Rebecca, the peace we have known for so long is now threatened. The land is dry. The Hittites want our wells. Who will stop them from taking them? Not Jacob.
All of you, take heed. The first man who approaches my father's well will feel the bite of my sword.
Put by your knife, Esau. You're my friend. I don't want your blood on my hand.
Our flocks are parched, and our land is dry. We have a right to the well.
Right? What right? My father's servants dug it.
On our land.
This land was barren and deserted till we brought water to it. You never used it.
We'll use it now.
Try. You are outnumbered, Esau. Don't be stubborn.
I have the Lord on my side.
I've heard differently. Now that you've married our sister.
Perhaps now's the time to put it to the test.
Wait! Put up your sword, Esau! Let them have the well!
Your death will profit no one. I pray you, let me speak to him a moment.
Esau, this is hopeless. They have us completely outnumbered.
But we have God on our side.
I wish I could be as sure of such things as you and Mother seem to be. In any event, I'm sure he'd rather have us settle things peacefully.
You mean surrender?
That old well is running dry, Esau. Let them have it. We'd do better to dig new wells nearer to our own habitations.
But how will we find water?
Ah, but you just now said that God is on our side. This is true. He'll lead us to water.
It shall be as Jacob counseled. You may have the well.
Are you still looking for work, Perua?
I am.
Come along, then. There'll be plenty of work for all.
Bring your tools. Start digging. Come on.
The work went on, and the well finally brought forth their precious water. God's will had been done through Jacob. Now there was to be water for all. As the years passed, the wasteland of Canaan once again became fertile. The flocks multiplied, and the two tribes worked side by side to reap the rich bounty the Lord had provided.
You see, my wife, the Lord is still good to us, even though Esau is married to Bathsheba.
The Lord's been good to Jacob. Jacob told us where to dig for water.
He's done well. I'm not denying that. I'm pleased with both my boys.
Now, Father!
Do not be alarmed, Esau. We come in peace.
Whereas your God has led you to water, and our gods have been unable to do so, our gracious ruler affirms your God as greater than ours, and hereby resolves that a covenant of peace shall prevail among his people and the children of Isaac.
You may tell your great sovereign that I appreciate his kind words, that I and my heirs will abide by the spirit of the covenant.
You see? It was Esau's doing. He showed a bold front and showed the Hittites we couldn't be trifled with.
No matter what I do, it will always be Esau who gets the credit.
Productive for the Hebrew tribes, but they had left Isaac blind and near death.
Esau.
I'm here, Father.
I'm an old man, my son, and I cannot see. And the day of my death draws near.
Don't talk that way, Father. You still have many good years left to you.
Don't feel bad. Good life. loving wife, two wonderful sons. And the Lord has blessed me with prosperity. And this too shall pass on to you.
My only wish for you, Father, is to get well.
That is as God wills. But he saw.
Yes.
I do crave one more time for the magnificent venison they used to bring to me. Prepared so nice and juicy. The way you make it. Take the bow and go into the fields and bring it back to me so that I may bless you before I die.
You actually think I can get Isaac's blessing by pretending to be Esau?
Yes, I do.
It won't work, Mother. Esau's hairy and I'm not. Father's sure to feel the difference when he embraces me.
I know a way to make it seem as though you have as much hair as your brother.
And suppose it fails? My father's blessing could turn into a curse.
Then let the curse be on me. Now, do as I say. And, oh, good. Now you will have as much hair as your brother Esau.
Why must I wear Esau's clothes? They're much too large for me.
So that you will smell like him as well as feel like him.
Father won't smell anything but that meat.
Good, and it's fixed just the way he likes it. Go, fetch it to him.
Oh, Lord, my God. What is your will? Am I to deceive my father, whom I love, and betray my only brother, whose love I cherish? Will this fulfill the prophecy? Is this your wish?
Who is it?
It's me, Esau. I've done what you asked.
You have found your deer very quickly.
Because the Lord your God brought it to me.
Come closer, my son. I want to feel you. I'm sorry, Esau. That is your hand. For a moment, your voice sounded like Jacob. Are you really Esau?
I am.
Pour me some wine. You have outdone yourself, my son. It's more tender than usual. Kiss me, my son. That is the smell of Esau. Like the smell of the field which God has blessed. Kneel down, my son. May God give you the fattest harvest. Plenty of grain and wine. Let the people serve you and nations bow down before you. You will be the lord over your brethren. And your mother's sons will bow down to you. Cursed be to anyone who curses you. And blessed be all who bless you.
With the birthright and now the blessing, the inheritance of leadership and wealth was now Jacob's, not Esau's.
Here I am, Father.
Who is it?
Esau, whom did you expect? I brought you your venison.
You are Esau.
Of course. Now eat it before it gets cold.
I have already eaten. Someone brought me venison. He said he was Esau. And I have given him the blessing that I intended for you. It was Jacob.
First he takes my birthright, then he takes my blessing.
I have made him the Lord over you. And what should have been yours? What can be left for you, my son?
Hear me, Jacob. You have stolen my birthright and my blessing. And for this you will die! I would not cause our father pain in his last hours. But I swear to you, your death will follow hard upon his.
It was silly to have me hide out all night, Mother. I cannot believe Esau wants to kill me.
I heard him.
People often say I'll kill you when they're angry, but it's a long way from the word to the deed. Anyway, he said he wouldn't do it while Isaac was alive.
Who knows how much longer your father will be with us? And after he dies, it'll be too late for you to run to safety.
Well, how can I just get up and leave? What excuse will I give Father?
No excuses, Jacob. The truth.
Rebecca?
Yes. Is there anything that you need?
No, as long as you're contented.
Oh, Isaac.
Is something troubling you, my angel?
Esau has threatened to kill Jacob. And I fear that after you die, Jacob will be taken from me also.
Is Jacob here?
Yes, Father.
Come closer, my son. You deceived me. I should be very angry with you.
Please forgive me, Father. I thought I was carrying out God's will, yet my heart grieves me for what I've done. I'd do anything at all to atone.
You mean those words?
I swear it, Father.
And the Lord God will forgive you as I do.
If only I could undo the wrong to Esau. I never meant to harm him, Father.
What's done is done. Perhaps it was God's will. It may be that you are more fit to rule than your brother.
I love Esau, Father. I didn't want to trick him. I only did what I thought was right.
I believe you, my son. But Esau now wants your life. I'd let that happen. So I'm sending you to Paden Aram, to the home of your uncle Laban, and there you will choose a wife. And when Esau's anger is gone, you will return and rule our people. Go down, Jacob.
Goodbye, Father.
Goodbye, my son.
Mother?
I'll never see you again. I know it.
Nonsense.
For everything that's happened, I take the sins upon my head. It's the price I must pay.
Esau is wild with rage. The only reason you will not kill Jacob is that Isaac still lives.
Why tell us, little sister?
If he murders his own brother, he'll be banished by his people. And I'll be forced to go with him, to wander this land forever. I might never see my people or family again. But if an accident should befall Jacob, well, then it would not be Esau's fault.
An accident?
Then you and your husband would stand to gain the whole of Isaac's inheritance.
And you have the money Esau owes you, and more.
The road to Beit Danaram is long and treacherous.
He would not be the first traveler to be killed by thieves.
Jacob.
Who is it?
Perua. I've come to warn you. Apek and Hassan are on your trail. They mean to kill you.
Kill me? Why? I've done them no harm.
As a favor to Behemoth, you must hide.
Where shall I go? Into the wilderness? I'd be lost.
You and your father have been good to me. I wish there was some way I could help you.
Perhaps there is.
Him off, Jacob.
No, Perua. I am sparing your lives so that you may carry a message back to Esau. Tell him I beg his forgiveness and will spend as many years as the good Lord grants to make up for the wrong I've done him. Now hurry before I change my mind. Thanks again, good friend.
My pleasure. I have a feeling they won't be bothering you much anymore.
You may spend the night here if you like.
No, I'd better be getting back.
God be with you.
And with you, Jacob.
Lord, please help me now in my time of need. I've been forced from my home, hated by my brother, hunted by his friends. Is this the fulfillment of the prophecy? Am I doomed to a life separated from my people? Or shall I one day return home to humbly serve you? Please, Lord, speak to me. Tell me.
Still, the questions went unanswered. In Jacob's search for God's will, he had found only confusion and resentment, but not the answer he desperately needed. Tired, weary, and discouraged, there was nothing more he could do. He made his camp, but sleep was not to come easily.
Father, and you will suffer as Esau has suffered. but I shall remain with you always. And one day, you shall return and reclaim this land.
Praise to you, my lord. I will set up a pillar to mark this place, pour oil on top of it. This will be a symbol of our covenant, my undying love and devotion.
And so at long last, a confused young man had finally found his God. Jacob would be forgiven by Esau and would one day return to Canaan. Here he would be judged so great that the Lord was to change his name to Israel.